You ever come across a game, take one good long look at everything in it, and instantly think, wow, Australia's outdone itself this time? Yeah, that was my first impression of Monster Hunter World, and it still rings true after playing it for a while. Seriously, the only thing the new world is missing is spiders the size of dogs. Large dogs! Oh, and before I forget to introduce myself, hi there. My name's Dragon. I'm a variety streamer who normally has a bit of a foul mouth, but I've gotta censor myself in this series to keep the YouTube overlords from smothering the series in its sleep. So to kick off this little project of mine, why don't we start off with the beasts who give you your warm and toothy welcome to the new world? No, not the giant volcano turtle. I'm going in order of the assigned hunts here so he can wait his turn just like everyone else. We're starting off with the lizard dogs, better known as the Jagras. The Jagras, like many of the creatures in Monster Hunter, is a chimeric combination of two different kinds of animals, lizards and canines. And I'm going to keep using canines from this point on because if I don't, every idiot, including me, is going to want to pet these things and then will end up losing their hands if I keep calling them dogs. They're colored in yellow and blue scales, with some of them being a lot brighter with orange-tipped spines. This leads me to believe that there's a bit of sexual dimorphism going on here. For those who don't know, sexual dimorphism refers to the clear differences between the males and females of a species. The most well-known examples of this are the birds of paradise. The females of those species look like normal birds, while the males are definitely letting that freak flag fly. It's like watching someone who's had too many margaritas hanging out at a pride event, and I am loving it. Back to the Jagras, I believe the males are the ones that are dull in color, while the females are the ones that you could see from a mile away. My reasoning for this will be pretty clear later on in the video, so keep watching. Or don't. I'm not holding you hostage. You're free to leave at any point, and I'm not gonna stop you. Still here? Alright, onto the way these things behave. The Jagras are opportunistic pack hunters. Typically a small number of the pack goes to one area to hunt, the pack leader goes off on his own to hunt, and the rest stay behind at the nest to guard it and, I'm assuming, any babies that are in there. The main reason I call them opportunistic hunters is something that I had a fun time finding out while playing the game. If you knock down a large monster while a group of Jagras are nearby, the Jagras will ignore you, the hunter who just told a creature several times your size to sit down and stay down, and will instead focus on ripping into the prone beast until he gets back up or dies. You presented them an opportunity for an easy feast, and they're not going to waste their time asking if you planned on eating it. But this is not the only way the pack feeds themselves. Remember that pack leader I mentioned going off by himself? Well, I would like to introduce you to the Great Jagras. Great Jagras are exactly what it says on the tin. Bigger and stronger Jagras who decided that having canine traits wasn't as cool as just being a full-on giant lizard with a mane. A lion's mane, to be more specific, because like the leading male lion in a pride, his main purpose in his life is to make more Jagras with all the females in the pack, which are definitely the brighter colored Jagras. Also, like a male lion in a pride, he's the only one allowed to multiply without a calculator, which means the other males are his sons he hasn't yeeted out of the nest yet, or they're kept around as backup in case the great Jagras keels over and the pack needs a new baby maker ASAP. Don't get me wrong, however, he doesn't just laze about in the nest waiting for his next Tinder date. He earns his keep. Like I said earlier, he goes off on solo hunts for the pack. Like a snake, the great Jagras has a collapsible jaw, which he uses to swallow his prey whole. Once he's got his most likely still alive victim stuffed down his expanding gullet, he lumbers off back to the nest while the powerful stomach acid in the big guy's belly puts the prey out of their misery. Ugh. Once he gets back home and gets the attention of the rest of the pack, he vomits up the partially digested groceries for his family to eat right up. After making sure they've eaten, he lumbers back out to hunt for either just himself or to get seconds for the pack, which is surprisingly wholesome for an apparent monster. But here's something to keep in mind with the Jagras and Great Jagras. Here on Earth, they'd be apex predators that would be a constant threat to humanity. In the world of Monster Hunter, they're only one step above the herbivores on the food chain. Do with that information what you will. So that is going to be it for today. For those who did tune in, I do hope you enjoyed. If you've got any constructive criticism for me, feel free to leave it down in the comments, as I can't improve it at this if I don't know what I'm doing wrong and what I'm doing right. Also, go give me a follow on Twitch and join the Discord. But as always, my name is Dragon, and bye-bye!